So here we can check like how we can create doggos with respect to a new part we can take. So we can take a new part somewhere here. And once we have that, we can name that as a doggos. Okay, so basically why we required the doggos? Okay, so the doggos we required whenever we want to be add a b-side feature, and with respect to that b-side feature, it's very difficult to reach the height of BIW or any another part we're going to be assemble. Okay, so in that case, what limitations we have? Suppose we have locator, something like this. Okay, so this locator will be there, and with respect to locator, the BIW is something here. Okay, so we have our optimum minimum, what are we going to be have the availability of space we can do the adding the b-side feature. So here you can check like we're going to be have this as a BIW, and whatever we have the limitation to part. Okay, so whatever we want to maintain the root thickness, that 40 to 60%, as well as whatever we're going to be have the height to that ratio. Okay, so at the tip we're going to be have 0.8. okay, so that is also we have the limitation, as well as the draft what we're going to be provide, that should be the 0.5. So with respect to this constraint, we are not allowed to go further beyond the height. Okay, so if this particular BIW is beyond the height of water, we have the design rule. Okay, design guideline for injection molding part. So with respect to that, we require the doggos. That is nothing but the additional feature we're going to be add. Okay, so additional feature that we're going to be add to increase the height of B side feature. Suppose if we add something like doggos, okay, in that case we can raise the height of locator. Okay, in this case you can increase the locator somewhere here. Okay, and that is possible. So there will be no sink mark at the bottom, and definitely we need to remove the coring. Okay, we will remove the metal over here, and that is known as a coring. So that we can do with respect to that, we can add this feature to the BIW height. Okay, so here the constraint we are considering is something like BIW will not come down with their any constraint limitations they have. Okay, so this is something like we're going to be check with respect to how we can add a doggos. We have seen what is the purpose to have a doggos, what is the purpose we're going to be have for add a doggos in a plastic component. Okay, so we have started with the part. Okay, so we need to create two geometric set. One will be for the input. Okay, so whatever we're going to be create the feature, for that we need to have always the input. And second is something like the work or anything you are doing construction, so that we need to add somewhere here. Okay, so in input we always keep point. Okay, so firstly we hide this particular three planes what we have basically in CAD part. Okay, so that we are not required right now, because every car we're going to be have the separate coordinates will come with that 0 0 itself. So we required over a point, so we'll add a point into the input with coordinate. Now you can take any coordinate 20 50, 100. So at that particular point, we need to add a doggos. Okay, so this point might be changed with respect to the coordinate, and we can name this point as an input point or the start point. Okay, so with respect to this point, you can might do the annotation something like this. So from that we need a tooling line, so we'll create one line with respect to right now as a z direction. Okay, so it's not fixed, we can change later on anything. Okay, and here also you keep some distance, something like 150 200, something like fixed length. Okay, so it depend upon the OEM what format they're going to have. So this is something like we have created the line, you can name that line as a tooling line. Tooling line, tooling direction, what will be feasible, that will be the name. Tooling line, you can fix something like this as a center line. You can create something like this. Okay. So this is how you're going to be create the tooling line as well as a start point. And with respect to that, there will be another lifter direction that we need to add. Okay. So here we're going to be considered as a wire direction. So create in y direction one line that we can name as a lifter direction. Okay, so this will be lifter direction, and the properties you can match from here, and the color will be always different. You can use highlighted color, yellow, green, or dark color. These are the color most of the time use. Okay, so we'll go with this particular yellow now. Now this is nothing but the input we want. Okay, and with respect to this three only, whatever we're going to be create, that will be link. As we move the point, whole geometry going to be move. That is our thing we need to create. Okay, so that is called as a parametric model. So now in work, what we're going to do, we'll have something like plane first. So we'll create a plane normal to the tooling line passing through the point. Okay, so whatever we're going to be create, the dogos we are creating from the point and tooling line with respect to lifter direction. Okay, so else we are not going to be use axis system right now. We'll see separately how we can create the axis system. From axis system also how we can derive the dogos. Okay, or any B-side region. So here we have created the plane, and with respect to the plane, we need to have a sketch. Okay, so we'll draw a sketch. Okay, over here, with respect to the point projection over here, then we'll try to always keep vertical axis over here. So we always try to keep vertical over here, horizontal over here. Okay, so what is the reason? So reason is something like whatever you're going to be draw. Whatever you're going to be draw, the shape will not be rotate. What you draw onto the sketch, the same will be reflect in front side of you. Okay, so this is the only reason you can keep V and H something like this. Like whenever you're going to be draw in a sketch, so that will be reflect as the same triangle, same orientation, same position. Okay, so we can just rotate this vertical axis with respect to this. Okay, so you can change the direction where we want, something like this. V and H will help us to move further. Now you can find we need to link this line to. Okay, so this horizontal axis we need to link with this orientation. Okay, so here we have in sketch position, we have the reference so that we can select the position. Then we have the orientation, we will select the point, that center point. Then we have the orientation over here. Here we have the origin, here we have the orientation. We can select this is multiple option XYZ line axis, or we can select the parallel to line. Right now we can select parallel to line with H or V, they are mentioned over here. Okay, like we already sweep that particular, so that way it's not going to be come like this. You can sweep it again, make it horizontal as parallel to this. So whenever we try to rotate the angle, so this H will be tried to rotate. Okay, and with respect to that, whatever the sketch we have, so that will be changed. So this is how we're going to be create a sketch. And now in this particular sketch, we need to create one square. Okay, square of something like 20 by 20 right now. So you can use any of the dimension depending upon the requirement of our dogos. We can change that dimension. So here we're going to be have 20 by 20 right now. So this is something like you can create a sketch which will be green. And now you can find we have linked this particular with respect to H. Okay, so now if we just have a pad, so for that we need to add new body. Okay, so this body we can name as a main body. And into this main body we can create a doggo something like this. We're going down with respect to 30. So you can add 30 value. Going down, then we need to add draft. Okay, draft to the faces rather than lifter face. Okay, so here we have the lifter direction, so this face is not going to be removed to the tooling direction. So rest of the thing we need to remove in tooling direction. Okay, so these three faces we need to add a draft to remove the part upside in tooling direction. So we'll select a draft command. We can select the faces we want to give draft, as well as we need to select the neutral element over here with respect to that the plane we can select. Then we need to select pulling direction. So pulling direction is nothing but the tooling direction. Okay, so pulling direction we need to select as a tooling direction. With respect to that, you can check the preview. Arrowhead should be upside. Okay, arrowhead should be upside. So how you can remember this arrowhead? You can just make a sense of something like the temple. So temple will always have something like at the top. Okay. So whenever you select the arrow, so with respect to that, whatever the face you have selected, neutral, top or the bottom. Suppose you have selected now top. So whatever you have the face, that will be get inside. Okay. Suppose you have selected this top face and you have selected the bottom surface. So you can imagine the arrowhead is upside. It means something like from here you're going to be start downside. Okay. So this is something like the angle going to be deviate with respect to arrowhead. Okay, so you can make you are making reference from here or here. So with respect to that, it's depend. It's going to be inside or outside. Okay, so that will be make a sense. So here you can check. Now we will keep the arrowhead upside and angle will give 3 to 5 degree as the, even this is a B side feature. We don't want to make it a complication for a toolmaker to remove these stoppers. Okay. We want to make it as easy as possible, so we can give 5 degree and click OK. So once you click OK, you can find if you view into the tooling direction, you'll get these three surfaces now are open to tooling line, okay, rather than this surface. So same way, we're going to be have the lifter. So for lifter also, we need to clear the surfaces so we can add draft to these surfaces. So what is showing the error? Error is something like the face is already drafted. Still, we want to go for yes. We want to have the draft over there. So rather than whatever we have the surface of bottom, so all the three surface we can take a draft for this particular lifter direction. So what will be the neutral element we can select? You can select the neutral elements over here at the front side. Okay, I have the pulling direction. Pulling direction will be lifter direction now, and the arrowhead will be opposite because what we create over here, so that will be create the outer side. Okay. So it going to be create. We want to remove this later on. Okay. So for that reason, we want to be create the opposite side. If you create outside, it will be remove the faces, but it will be create inside gap. Okay. So why we are going to be take that? Because we need to create something like thickness kind of thing. Okay. So in that case, this inner surface will be get undercut. Okay. So we'll check that once it created, you will understand why we have taken this particular surface in opposite direction. Okay, so we can create in opposite direction something like this. So once we remove inside material, it will be removed this side. Okay, already we are going to be remove this in tooling direction. There is no issue. So once we finish with that draft, we need to add fillet. Okay, so we need to add fillet. With respect to that, you can check, we will go for vertical first. Okay, always try to maintain the vertical first. 3 to 5 mm we can add fillet over here, so we'll go for the 3 mm, and then you can add for the top. So what is logic over here? So if you are selected in the one fillet, so we need to select 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, so 5 selection we need to do over here. With the 2 command, we need to select only 3 faces. Okay, so that is something like the when you do fast CAD model. Okay, so in that case, you need to create something like this. So here you can find we're going to be have something like this. Okay, so we added first pad with respect to sketch, then draft with respect to tooling line, then we added draft with respect to slider lifter line, then we added a fillet somewhere here. Okay, with respect to this. Okay, as well as you can find something like this, we're going to be add. Now we need to do the shell. So before doing the shell, we need to add another body. Okay, so we added another body so that we can name as a main body. Sorry, we can add that as a doghouse body or doghouse. So we can add this with the boolean operation. So if you right click on this particular and go to the main body object, we'll get this boolean operation over here. Okay, so we need to add, so we can add this. Okay, so before that, we need to do a coring. So coring will do with respect to this only. So we'll copy this. Okay, then right click over here on doghouse, then select the space special. Okay, space special we do with link. Okay, so what it means, whatever we have created, that will be the shape, is copy paste with link. So any changes we do over here, it will be changed. Okay, so this we're going to be used for the coring. So we can name as coring or core out or remove of the material, anything you can name. So this main body we can now add into the boolean operation, right click, go for add. You can add something over here. So as soon as you're going to be add over there, it will be add a plus sign when we add over here. Okay, so this is a pad we have. Clear? So this is how we added draft for this particular part with respect to fillet. This is called as a main body. Now we need to do the shell. So for shell, we can select over here this particular command. So we can select somewhere here as well as here. We can keep the part thickness, but right now we'll go for the 2 mm. Okay, so you can keep up to part thickness. So you can see, like, once you give the shell, the thickness of the part, this box will be created as a 2, and we need to remove the inside portion with the lifter direction. For that reason, we are given the draft in opposite direction. So these faces will be get clear in lifter direction. Okay? So this is the main purpose we're going to be have. And then we need to do coring. Okay, so the coring we can do somewhere here. We need to add another plane. Okay, so we already seen for where exactly we're going to be have the coring. Coring is nothing but the material remover. Coring is nothing but the material remover at a height of 3 to 5 mm. Okay, at a height of 3 to 5 mm to make sure 40% root thickness. To make sure 40% root thickness, 40 to 60, depending upon part material. To make sure there will be no sink mark. Okay, so this is the reason we're going to be add the coring. Coring is also known as a removal of material at the root thickness of the side feature. Okay, so this is how we're going to be add the coring now for 3 to 5 mm height. So for that 3 to 5 mm, we can take a plane reference what we already have. So we can refer that plane at somewhere 25 from top. So this will be 5 mm from the bottom we can consider. And we will hide for time being this particular dog horse body, and we can work on now coring or material remove. So I'll just give color to not get confused with respect to this. So in coring, what we need to do first, we need to remove this top face. So we'll use this command as split. So we can select the split from the downside arrowhead. Whatever we want to keep on that way, we're going to be have the arrowhead. So you can keep over here. So something like this material we have. Now we have the part thickness, consider the 2.5 mm. Okay. So part thickness, we have 2.5 mm. So for that 40% will be something like you can calculate. It's 1 mm. Okay, so what is a one? What we have 1 mm out of that 40%, something like 0.4. Similar to that, plus 1 will be 0.4. Similar to that, additional 0.5 divided by this 2 divided by this 2 will be 0.2. So this is how it's going to become 1 mm. So in interview, it's very difficult to go for the 40-60% what we're going to be have. So you can simplify this with respect to, so you can orally also you can give the answer what is the 40% of 2.5. So here we need to have a root thickness of 1 mm. So that much thickness we can minus. So that much thickness we can minus with the minus 1. We'll use this thickness command and we can remove the material. Okay. So something like this we can do. And we need to have fillet as well as draft. So we'll add a draft on top face. Select this particular face over here. Add a draft 0.5, because that is, we'll add the more draft, it will be going to be a change in angle over here. Okay, so we'll keep something like 0.5 draft just to make sure part will be get removed. And arrowhead we need to select something like this, opposite direction. Okay, so if you have selected this face, arrowhead will be downside, it will go downside in opposite direction. And now we need to remove this part from our existing body. Okay, so here we are doing the Boolean operation. And if you want, you can add the fillet to this particular top face in coding itself. So you can add this fillet of 1 mm, 2 mm, that will be fine. And finally, we can remove this. Right click, remove. We'll add over here something like this. And this will be get removed. Okay, we can directly add a fillet at the bottom over here in this particular area. We can add 1 mm, 0.5 mm, something like fillet. And this is how we're going to get the doghouse. Okay, so what we have done with respect to this doghouse, so you can just do the draft, and as you can find, the surface will be removed upside. This is something like we're going to be up. The surface will be removed upside. Okay, so this can create a doghouse with respect to this particular line. Okay, we'll just go for the recap. Whatever we're going to be seeing over here, it's something like we're going to be create over here what we have created first. So here you can find, so we have created first pad. Okay, so with respect to pad, we are given the draft pad. We have created 20 by 20 with the tooling line point and this particular lifter. Okay, then we have created the draft with respect to tooling line. Then we have created a draft with respect to slider line. Rather than the sliding face and bottom face, we can give the draft to the three faces. Then we added a fillet. Fillet will be vertical first. Okay, vertical first. Then we're going to be add a fillet horizontal. Then we move this main body into the add one. Then we added shell. Shell with the 2 mm thickness. Okay, so 2 mm thickness we added for the shell. With respect to that, we can add again for coding command. Okay, we have copy paste over here with the link. Then we have done the split for 3 to 5 mm. We need to do the coding over here, remove that material. So that we added. Then we added a thickness, that is a minus thickness we need to do to maintain the 40% root thickness. Then again, we have done the draft. So to remove the upper surface, when we core out. Then we added fillet. Then finally, we can add fillet over here. Add the remove and then fillet is okay. So this is something like we're going to be do toggles with respect to this geometry we have created. Okay. So now we'll check for the power copy, how to create power copy for any feature, any B-side feature. So with respect to this particular part, we're going to be have input as well as work that we have created already. So we need to create a power copy. So basically, why exactly we required the power copy? Okay. So the power copy is required. Power copy is required to add this particular feature at n number of time. Okay. So here you can find in this particular doggos, in this particular doggos. Okay. So in all this area, we're going to be add the doggos. And for that purpose, we now need to create whatever the time we are waste over here to create this particular. So we'll not waste the same time to create over here. Okay. So for that purpose, the power copy is used. So this is similar to the what we are going to be having Microsoft copy paste. So we can copy this, we can paste over here, copy this, paste over here, copy this, paste over here. So same thing we can do at n number of time, not only in this part, we can add into the another part as well. We can do the copy paste. So for that reason, we're going to be use power copy. Okay. Someone asked me the question regarding can we go for what is the difference between the power copy and pattern? Okay, so definitely there is a difference. Okay, so we'll check over here. We're going to be create first power copy, and at what particular point we're going to be create. For that, you need to create new geometric setup. So we will create a new geometric set that will be doghouse 2. Okay, so in doghouse 2, we'll create a point. Point will be something like it will be. one twenty from here, so we can say 100 mm will be the gap between the two doggos. So we need to create one doggos with respect to apart from 100 mm from here. So that is a doggos 2 point start point. Then tooling line will keep the same, and we need to have a slider lifter line. Okay, so lifter direction we can create as a x. So here we need to create the x direction. Definitely need to color. You can match the property. You can change the color if required. Then we need to add power copy over here with respect to three inputs. Tooling direction we already have, point we have created, then this particular we have created. Okay, so these are the three input we require. So how to add power copy? Okay, so power copy you can add from the insert, go to over here knowledge template and check for the power copy. Okay, go to the insert knowledge template and check for the power copy. Once you select, you need to select what you're going to be add over here. Okay, so this is a selection one and this is the input you want. So if you select this doghouse body, so all the relation what we're going to be have inside that will be selected. Now it will automatically select what are the input we're going to be used. So here we have the input sketch, plane and all these things. Okay, so plane we are created with respect to some reference. This plane also we are created with tooling line and point. Sketch we are done on the plane. So this input we want. Okay, so what we want, start point, lifter direction as well as tooling line. So these are the three input we require. So we can click on OK And once we click the OK, you can find at over here the body, it will be created as a power copy. Okay, so this is the power copy is going to be created. So you can copy this particular name, Doggos. You can name this power copy as a Doggos power copy. Okay, something like you can create. And with respect to that, you need to do it again with at this particular point. Okay, so how we can recall the power copy? So I don't think there is a doubt with respect to this, how to create a power copy. But again, I can explain. To create a power copy, you need to go to the tool, insert, knowledge template, then power copy. Once you select the power copy, you need to select this. Okay, and what are we going to be have the left and right? Okay, that we're going to be okay. So once you select, and you will have somewhere here. So what do you want in input that you can keep, and what do you want in select? So that will be go over here. Okay, you can shift to the left, and this is nothing but the input required when you're going to be create. So this particular things need to be there already created. By default, whatever we have added over here, so that automatically get created. Okay, so now we'll recall the power copy. So how we can recall the power copy? Go to the insert. With respect to that, you can find there is another term over here. Instantaneous from the selection we need to do. So there is another option, we have the document, so that we'll see separately. So you can find instantaneous from the selection, you need to select, then you need to select the power copy, this particular. So once you select, automatically the window will be pop up. Okay, so what is saying, so what are we going to be create over here? It's something like the tooling line slider direction and start point we need to give. So first it's asking for the tooling line. Okay, so you can select the tooling line. Arrowhead should be match. Okay, then we selected lifter direction, so that we can select over here. Then it's we need to select start point. So we already have created start point. Check for the preview always before adding to anywhere. Just check for the preview. You can find this Doggos body is created. Okay, so now why we have selected the arrowhead upside? What will be happen if you are reverse that? So you can check this arrowhead in upside. This we have selected downside. You can find the Doggos will be get inverted. Okay, so this is something like it will be moving inverse side direction. So we don't want that. We want in this direction itself. So that's why we are selecting the same arrowhead. Over here, the same condition. We need to select another direction over here. So it will be create something like this. So if we are selected, like whenever we're going to be have this tooling line. Okay, so if you are inverted, check for the preview, it will be get inverted. Okay, so we need to keep the same direction over here, as well as you can check for the lifter direction what we're going to be have, so that you're going to be changed with respect to that. The Doggos will be changed its orientation. Okay, so for now we can keep the same, we're not going to be changed. And once you click okay, okay, after once you click the okay, then only it's going to be create the Doggos over here. That is a second Doggos. So we can name that, rename that separately, we can make that possible. Okay, so you can name this possible second, and with respect to that, you can change any dimension over here. Okay, so what are we going to be have all the values, so that values also we can change. Okay, so here we can change with the 25, 35, that we can change, as well as you can find somewhere here we're going to be created. So anything we can change without changing the first one, as well as you can separately change the first Doggos. Okay, so this is how we're going to be change the first Doggos with respect to the sketch, but the another one is not going to be changed. Okay, so this is something I will create a 14 intentionally. So here you can find it's only change over here, it will not change this particular new one. Okay, so what are we going to be changed the Doggos? That are two are nothing but the independent now. Okay, so these and these are the nothing but the independent right now. And with respect to that, we can find we have created the Doggos power copy. What we have additional one, so that we can create, and with the minimum optimum input, you can create at n number of times. This is a time saving command we're going to be have as a power copy. Okay, so in next time we're going to be see how to create a power copy with respect to the document. Okay, and as well as we can check, like if you want to create a power copy in another part, so this we have seen for the same part, so you can see into the another part how to create a power copy in another part. Suppose we are going to be create a one part. Okay, so we can create over here part 2. So in this part we're going to be add power copy. So you can just go for the same input. We can add the geometric set, or there you need to have a point. So you can create a point anywhere. Okay, so to avoid the confusion, we can create over here 200. Okay, and we want a power copy over here. So for that, here there is no tooling line. So we can select the tooling line, you can select the point, direction, tooling line, we can select now as a X. Okay, so this will be the X direction we are selecting as a tooling line. Now we need to select lifter direction. So lifter direction we can select as a Y over here. Okay, something like this we can create. So you can name this for convenience as a tooling line. This we can name as lifter direction. This will be start point. Okay, now we want to create the power copy at this particular junction. Okay, so here you can just give the power, change tooling line color, lifter direction color. Okay, so now we need to add the power copy over here. Okay, from the another part, so we can create. So same process we need to follow. First we need to follow something like this: insert, then instantaneous form selection we need to select, then without clicking anywhere you can go to the window, then another doggos, then select power copy. Don't click anywhere else, directly select power copy, left click, can directly come up to the another part with respect to this tooling line, lifter line, and what are the input you are given. Okay, so here we can go for that, selecting this particular tooling line first. So we have created tooling line over here, so we can select the tooling line, then lifter direction, you can select the lifter direction, then select the point. Okay, so we have selected tooling line, lifter direction, start point. Just check for the preview. So once you created the preview over here, so it will be get created in which direction we are created. Okay, so if you just change the tooling direction in the opposite direction, it will be inverse. Okay, as well as you can inverse this lifter direction, it will be inverse. Okay, so depending upon the arrowhead you, if you want to keep, okay, whenever, wherever you want, you can change that. So it's not something like whenever we're going to be have the toggles, it has to be in same direction. Okay, so whatever we're going to be created with respect to that, you can find, we can create the doggos wherever we want. Okay, so this is something like we can do the power copy in another part, not in the same part. Just make sure whenever you're going to be create the doggos, okay, make sure whenever you're going to be create the doggos, then power copy. So before click okay on power copy, you need to fix your directions. Okay, so if you want to go upside or the downside in this direction, which direction you want to doggos, just make sure fix that. And then you're going to be go for the okay to the power copy, because afterwards it's very difficult to edit that particular. Okay, because all the relation we have over here, and if you are wrongly selected, just delete that with the long history and again call the power copy. That saves the time rather than change in this particular thing. Okay, so you can change anytime later on once we applied, but whenever we are applying the power copy, and at that time only you can get that query like we are selected wrongly position, so you do it again. So that will be the good thing. Okay, so today we have seen something like how to create doggos, then we have selected, so we have studied how to do the power copy in same part, as well as we have seen how to do the power copy in another part with any feature with the minimum optimum input with respect to that. Okay, and it will be editable.